Here's the thing. I've been in love with the theater my whole life.
Every show that I had seen at Berkeley Rep totally blew my mind.
I think it's one of the most exciting places to be right now.
Berkeley Rep a lot of times just gets the best of the best in terms of design staff.
And there's just this energy.
There's really nothing that compares to working with the Tony Award-winning professional theater.
I applied to a bunch of these sort of transitional programs.
There aren't a lot of programs like this.
This is one of the few fellowship programs where you can really get in on the ground floor in terms of hands-on work.
It's the kind of experience that you can't get in school.
And you get to see how things really function, not theoretically, but practically.
People are really generous with their time and with what they know.
Every fellowship at Berkeley Rep has a mentor that's willing to help their mentee, aka their fellow, to grow into a better person.
I learned a lot from my mentor. He's awesome.
Kitty the Draper has been helping me a lot. She's sort of like my Tim Gunn.
He made it really clear that he cared about me as a person.
My mentors basically have like treated me like a valued member of their team.
And now that I'm no longer at Berkeley Rep as a fellow, I still call her.
My hope was to become an adequate carpenter, and I have definitely reached that and then some.
I've learned how to get the job done.
I've learned so much about directing. I've learned about planning a season.
How to be a professional stage manager and what that means.
Learning how to interact with people in a professional way.
A really healthy knowledge of contemporary plays.
I'm definitely most proud of the coming home artwork.
I made this pair of pants. I've never made a pair of pants before.
For a girlfriend, I got to paint this crazy fluorescent sunset.
I didn't think I'd find you perfect in so many ways, but I've been waiting, and I want to have you.
We raised $4,000 for the Matthew Shepard Foundation, which is fantastic.
I've been really active in writing articles for the programs.
I got to handle Billy Joe Armstrong's like 1956 electric guitars.
Don't wanna be an American idiot. Don't want a nation under the new media.
American Idiot was my favorite thing.
Plus, the housing, of course, was a great asset.
Living with other people who love theater as much as I do has been so wonderful for me.
It also creates, again, that sense of community.
It's been great because we all come from so many different places.
A diverse group of people that are so interested in so many different things has kind of pushed me out to do things that I never would have done.
This is a huge leap for me. Every day has a different challenge. It was like kind of jumping in the deep end, and good thing I know how to swim.
And that's hard, but it was really rewarding in the end.
It's definitely worth it.
I just feel like I'm on the path of where I need to be.
And that's been a real learning experience and a real privilege for me to be able to do.
It was a lot of fun. I mean, it's like the experience of a lifetime.
I feel like I could take the knowledge and run a theater company.
I feel like I'm prepared.
I'm ready to work.
And I am currently the artistic director of Crowded Fire Theater in San Francisco.
I am now the production manager and assistant to managing director at Brava for Women in the Arts.
What I most like to do in this world is build, and I'm able to do that pretty much on a weekly basis.
I can set my sights on the highest goal, and I will be able to reach it. And I think that it took this fellowship to help me to realize that. So
I mean, why not?